My name is Julia Koryceva. I'm a professor of ecology at School of Biological Sciences at Royal Holloway. And I'm teaching and coordinating the first year ecology course, which all our students who are doing organismal degrees like biology, ecology, leaf environment, and zoology are doing. And this course is really a combination of lectures, field trips, and lab practicals. It goes through the autumn term and spring term, and we have sort of top-down approach. We start with description of the global biomes, why climate varies at different parts of the globe, and then we narrow down to British ecosystems. We talk about woodlands, heathlands, chalk grasslands. Then we cover topics such as community ecology, population ecology. And during the second term, we also have a lot of sessions on sort of more topical issues of ecology, such as climate change and how it's going to affect plants and animals, and also conservation biology, conservation of biodiversity globally and in the UK specifically. And we think that it's very important for our students not just to listen to the lectures, but to get a sort of first-hand experience in using some ecological techniques. So we try, most of our practicals for this course are field-based. So, for instance, last week we took students to Box Hill, which is a lovely place near Dorking in Surrey. And this is an area of chalk grasslands, so the students use two different techniques to sample vegetation in that area, to look at plants which occur there. Just yesterday we had a practical which involved using our campus. We have a lovely campus which has a lot of woodland surrounding it. So we're using it in our teaching, and we had a walk around and looked at different trees, introduced species and native British species as well. In May, after the exams, we also have several field trips where we take students, for instance, to Dungeness, which is a very interesting shingle beach in Kent, where we study primary succession, because every year there are new ridges of shingle created there, and we look how vegetation changes. So we combine in this course both field trips, lab practicals, as well as lectures. In terms of my own research, I'm a zoologist by training, and specializing sort of in insects. But sort of over my career, I started to learn, to be interested more and more on plant sides of a story. So I'm studying interactions between plants and animals which feed on them, which range from tiny insects to large animals like moose. And here is one species I'm particularly studying. This is a leaf of horse chestnut, the tree which commonly grown in UK, in cities and in parks. And if you live in England, especially in southern parts of England, you probably noticed what recently, during the last few years, horse chestnuts don't look very healthy. The leaves are getting brown already in late summer, and then the leaves start to fall. And this is due to this little insect. It's called leaf miner, because the larvae live inside, they mine the leaf tissues, they live between upper and lower epidermis, and they create these brown spots. And there could be up to 700 mines per single leaf, so that's obviously not very nice for the tree. But we noticed what other hybrids or species of horse chestnut, red flowering ones, for instance, they are completely resistant to this leaf miner. And we are running a project together with scientists at Kew Garden, trying to understand whether differences in chemistry between these different species of horse chestnuts and hybrids could explain different resistance. And in general, over my career, I really started to get more and more interested in how plants respond to damage by insects, because very often students find plants a bit boring compared to animals. They say, well, plants don't move, they don't behave. But actually nothing can be further from the truth, because plants, if you think about how they sort of protect themselves against damage by different insects like this little moth, they have amazing array of mechanisms. They're nothing like passive players in this game. They can have chemical defenses, they might have different toxins or digestibility reducing compounds which affect development of pests. They can produce physical defenses like thorns or spines, and they can even hire bodyguards, they can attract natural enemies of these little herbivores, they can produce volatiles or gaseous signals which attract predators or parasitoids which come to the plant and eat the insects which are feeding on them. And even more, plants can talk to each other by means of chemical signals. They can warn each other about impending damage. What if there is a herbivore which is approaching and starting to feed on one plant, that plant might produce volatiles which inform the other plant and give it time to prepare for the defense. So all this research obviously has implications for agriculture and forestry. For instance, it can be used to develop the mechanisms of how we can make our crops more resistant to damage from pests and diseases. And the same for trees like horse chestnut. Can we use our knowledge, understanding of the mechanisms, how plants protect themselves, to improve the resistance of our ornamental trees or forestry trees to damage by pests and pathogens?